holding the baby. Quite literally.
Come on, we're going to get this.
We're going to get this.
We're going to get this.
It is our treat.
Exactly, no. Honestly, we promise. You guys come paid on. Last time. It's our go.
You guys always pay. Please let us pay.
No.
We insist.
Come on.
Come on, put your credit card away. Come on.
Come on. We've just...
Let us fucking pay!
What are you doing? What are you doing?
Let us pay or it's bye-bye, Rachel.
What are you doing, Mike?
Oh, Mike,
come
down.
No, Mary, they're always paying. Why can't we pay just for fucking once? Trying to make Mike look weak in front of his wife. Is that what this is about? Is it?
No.
Well, is this weak? Is it? This gun in her face. Me shooting your wife in the face because you won't let me pay. Is that weak?
Fine, you can pay. You're insane. What are you doing?
Actually, we didn't have a starter. And they did have a starter. Maybe you could get the tip or something to...
You get the tip.
Yeah. I'm not gonna dance for them today. I might shake my feet to the beat, but I'll shake them my way. Cause sometimes they make me run too fast. Sometimes they make me sing too loud. But I'm only singing out to get through the crowd. Mark, you don't have to do this.
I think I do.
Seriously, if you say you're a ninja, that'll do it for me.
Right, so why'd you laugh?
I thought you were joking.
Ninjas don't joke. Hold that up higher. Brace yourself.
Hey! Hey!
Oh, that's amazing!
Ow!
Is that meant to happen?
No, it's not.
Shall I call an ambulance?
Well, I can't do it, can I?
Okay, you hold these for me. Sorry.
Well, hello, emergency services.
So, where's the fire?
It's right here, in my balls.
Ah, oh, how did it start?
Well, I thought of you and suddenly, woof, my pants were alight.
Ah, oh, it's an inferno in there. Maybe you should try and cool down.
Well, maybe you should whip out my fat hose.
Oh, no. Why isn't the smoke alarm flashing?
Who knows?
Well, I mean, it just said it should be flashing, bang, bang, every 3 seconds.
Maybe the batteries are dead.
Oh, this isn't a fire door, is it? Because it should have been shut behind me.
I guess you can call me dangerous. Do you find danger a turn-on?
Okay. Oh. Let me tell you a little story about Rupert the rabbit.
Is Rupert a randy rabbit?
Nope, he's an irresponsible rabbit who didn't take proper care of his hutch. So one night, Rupert went to bed.
With Rebecca Rabbit?
No, it's a one rabbit hutch. Shh. So.
Does Rupert get laid at any point during this story?
No, he burns to death.
Jenny, I don't think we should do role play anymore.
Okay.
Daddy, why is the sky blue?
Well, it's all down to a physical phenomenon called Rayleigh scattering. Of all the colours in the spectrum, the colour blue is the most easily absorbed of all the colours. Thus, Kevin, the sky appears to be blue.
Daddy? Where does the sun go at night?
The sun doesn't go anywhere, Kevin. Like all the planets in our solar system, the Earth is in an elliptical orbit around the sun. But the Earth spins on its own rotational axis, completing one revolution every 23 hours and 56 minutes, which is why, Kevin, every 4 years we have a leap year.
Daddy? Why did Mummy leave?
With that in mind, I've had our entire research department working on interspecies breeding. Ladies and gentlemen, I think you're going to like this. I give you the Shunky. The first half shark, half monkey. Now, I think you'll agree with me when I say that the possibilities from here on are endless.
What does this Shunky have to do with projected profit margins for the next fiscal year?
Absolutely nothing. Next question.
Well, no, it's just that I'm here for a presentation on projected profit margins.
Good for you. Not what I was asked to do.
Yes, it is.
What?
Well, we were all hoping for a bit more on profit margins, but I'm sure we've all really enjoyed your theory.
Well, it's not a theory, is it? Because I had the scientists work on it for a while.
Scientists?
Yes. Hired them about a year ago.
Darren, how much of the company's money have you spent on this Shunky?
Shunky. It's pronounced Shunky.
Shunky.
About $4 million.
Pardon?
About $4 million. It's literally never been done before.
Right, ladies and gentlemen.
Right, so can I take it you don't like the Shunkies?
No.
Great, well, I've got a question. What am I supposed to do, right? I have got a warehouse full of 20,000 of them and they are going mental.
20,000?
Yes. Right, I suppose that's my fault, is it?
I might not get time to talk to Mum later, so would you mind giving her a call?
Yeah, sure.
So my keys?
No.
Young Tennyson coming up to the table.
Oh God, sorry.
Fine young player. Oh, that's an excellent shot. Excellent.
You're quite suggestible, aren't you?
Pull yourself straight back onto the pink and lay yourself short for that middle pocket.
Look, Andrew, it's not you, it's... we've both changed. No. I really think we... Hey!
Hey.
Hi. Listen, I really need to talk to you about something.
Oh, good. So do I.
Really? Great. OK.
Yeah, but you go first.
No, it's fine. You should go first.
No, it's fine.
You to try and go
first. OK, fine. We'll do it together.
Great, OK. On the count of three, then.
Fine.
OK, one, two, three.
I've won the lottery!
I want to break up with you!
What did you say?
I love you.
No. Oh, wait a minute. What did you say?
Nothing.
You did. You said... You said I want to break up with you.
No. What I said was, listen, I want to make some stuff with you.
Out of money!
It's twice good times. How much? Oh, shit. All right, where have you been all night?
You got a little cuddle for your brother?
No.
Oh. Oh, well.
Do you want to take your glasses off?
We were playing frisbee in the park and he fell through a window into a club.
Into a club? What? Sorry, why are you taking him to a club? He's 12 years old.
Hey, listen, we definitely didn't do any E's, right?
What?
I love you, Mum.
Stay there. What?
You got a cuddle for your brother?
No. You, get in. Take all that rubbish off. Not you. Stay there.
Boy, you got 100 quid on, bro.
Don't run, thank you, gentlemen. This is the lower school at Assembly Hall. We're an inclusive community. That's very much the keystone of our ethos. You know, I tell the children, I'm always at the end of the phone. If you need anything, any help, then I'm very happy to... I'm sorry, will you excuse me? That's one of them now, actually. Hello, Daniel. Right. OK, right. Well, break his legs. Yeah, get him across the bridge of the nose first. That'll blind him temporarily, then break his legs. Yeah, no, don't bother with that. You've got to get in first, yeah? Break his fucking legs. Yeah. And listen, don't forget that essay tomorrow, yeah? Yeah, later. Sorry about that. If you'd like to follow me through here, I'll show you the library.
Sean, have you got Marie's leaving card?
Yes.
Never think what to write in these things, can you?
Well, just sign your name and put a couple of kisses.
No, hang on. Ah, okay. Smash it.
So.
Thank you.
Sean, what's this?
Ah, kisses.
You've written fuck off, Harry.
Yeah, I have.
Have you met Maria?
No, I haven't. Who's Maria?
Maria, who's leaving.
Oh, is she a bit hairy? I don't want to sound rude.
No, she's not. She's very nice. She organised that 10-pin bowling thing last year. Why have you written this?
Well, it's just meant to sound a bit chummy, like we're old mates, you know? What did you want me to put? Good luck?
Well, yeah, that might have been a little bit more appropriate.
It is so nothing. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Fuck off, Harry. You know, which one stands out? Who looks like her best mate? Tell me that.
Well, I'd say Greg sounds like her best mate. Miss you loads. Mine's a double frappuccino. Oh, look, Lucy. Love you to bits, darling. Mwah, mwah. But not you, Sean, because you've written fuck off, Harry.
You're making it sound very aggressive.
It is, and it's the biggest message on the card.
Fine, I'll change it.
Thank you.
What is her name?
Maria.
Okay, Maria. There. Now it looks like I can't spell.
You can't.
Thank you. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, when you find out that the kid you raised the past 5 years as your own is not actually your kid at all, what choice do you have but to make that child's life as miserable as possible? Of course, if your biggest hit is a song that you wrote when that bastard son was born, because that's basically, that's what he is. He's a total bastard. And anyway, this next song's called Little Frankie. Yeah. Yeah. What do you do? Yeah. I sing it because you guys request it, but if you look closely, you'll see my eyes are dead when I sing the words, and I feel no emotion at all, only betrayal. Here we go.
Women like vulnerable men. See that woman over there? Go over and talk to her and make her feel like you need a woman to take care of you. I guarantee she will love it.
Really?
Bring out the mothering instinct.
Yeah, you're all right.
Go on.
Hi, I'm Sam. Too vulnerable?
Too vulnerable.
Hello?
Hey, I'm sorry, do you own a small tabby cat?
Yeah, well, my flatmate does.
I'm really sorry, but I just ran him over.
Yes! A high five! Thank you! Oh, that's brilliant. Bye! Karen, I've got some really bad news.
Dads have rights! Dads have rights! Dads have rights!
This is sexual discrimination!
My kids deserve to have a father!
Dads have rights! Dads have rights! Dads have rights! Dads have rights!
Is this so we get to see our kids, or so we don't get to see our kids?
Yeah, so we do get to see our kids.
What?
Dads have rights. We've got rights.
I'm gonna put that blusher.
I don't mind my face front on, but I can't stand my profile.
Oh, come on, don't be silly. You look lovely.
Well, I can't really see it, but I think I've got a double chin. What do you think?
No, you can hardly notice it. I don't. Just put a bit more lipstick on, maybe? I'm just gonna borrow this.
We're gonna go out and pull.
It's not been easy since Jane moved out. It's things like the cat. I mean, she was the one that always used to look after it. Still, I'm coping. Here you are, Napoleon. There you go. Yes. Cup of tea.
Car 12, have you made Church Grove pick up yet? Car 12, pick up at Church Grove?
No.
12?
No. I haven't made the pick up yet.
All right, where are you, 12?
I don't know!
All right, oh, you're a little bit lost again, 12. All right, there's a box of tissues under your seat. It's all right. Get a tissue, pop it under your nose and blow for me. That better?
Yeah.
Right, now look out the window. Are there any signs around?
Man and a lady.
All right, then, stop the car and ask the man and the lady where you are.
But I'm not allowed to talk to strangers.
Well, if you want to make the pickup, you're going to have to ask the man and the lady.
I don't want to make the pickup. I don't want to go in the car no more. I want to go.
12, you're going to be in a lot of trouble when car 4 gets back and I tell him you've been naughty. Right, now, is there anything you recognise?
Big sweet shop and trees.
Right, good, you're on East Street. You want to take first left past the playground and then you're on Church Grove right now. I want you to radio me when you've made that pickup, all right?
Okay.
Good boy, that's it.
I need a wee.
Oh, God.
I'm doing a wee.
All right, we'll come back and Auntie Carol will change you.
I'm doing a poo as well.
No, you see, I can't do that.
It smells. It's massive!
Wow, it's delicious.
I know.
You don't mind if I...
Oh, no, God, please. Please go right ahead. I didn't want to say anything, but your breath stinks. It's like all your teeth have done a shit. You go right ahead. Please spray.
Oh, it's just that it was really for my contact lenses.
Hello, please.
Hello, there's a lady here, man, and she needs some help.
Right, okay. Could you find out the lady's name for me, please, sir?
I can't. She's unconscious, but I've seen her around. She works on the beach, I think.
Well, she works on the beach?
Yeah, she sells seashells.
Right, and that's on the beach, isn't
it? Well, to be honest with you, little lady, Strictly is on the seashore.
Sorry, I didn't hear that. What'd you say?
On the seashore.
Okay, so this woman in question, she sells seashells on the... Karen! Stop it!
Go away and get drunk with me. I've opened a bottle of wine.
Very clever, well done. But I'm at work and it's 2 o'clock in the afternoon, so I'm just going to see you later.
I think you should come back now.
Oh, okay.
You could pull a sickie because someone could cover you and then you can come back. And we can, like, get really drunk and then we can go out and we can pull in things.
Right, this is genius.
Yeah! Actually,
yes, I will. I'll go and do that now.
Oh, really?
Yeah, bye.
Bye.
Hello, police.
God, those cinema seats are terrible. My neck's just killing me. Would you mind if I asked for a massage?
A massage?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Do you have any oils or anything?
Oils. Yes, I do.
Great. Thank you. It's a bit awkward asking, just... Well, most men, you know, they assume that if you ask for a massage, you want sex. No. Not at all. Not at all. I just want a massage. I ask for a massage. That's what I want. You know, you understand. You're different.
Thank God.
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, you've heard the prosecution argue, very persuasively, that my client is guilty of arson. You've heard his alibis be discredited. In fact, you've even seen him try to set fire to this courtroom in which we sit. But consider this. If you go now and return a verdict of guilty, then I will think that you are all gay. That's right. I will think that each and every one of you, oh, is a gay. And I will point at you in the street. And I will say, look at that gay. Look at those gays. They're properly gay. It's obvious. Is that what you want? To be a gay jury of gays? Do you want to be gay? You, do you want to be gay? Is that what you want? Maybe it is. Maybe it is. Defense rests, my lad.
My girlfriend's upstairs. Okay, you guys sit there. Who wants a drink?
Yeah, beer.
Shh, keep it down, remember?
What time is it?
Babe!
What's going on?
Nothing.
Well, I can hear voices. Who's here?
There's just some mates from the pub just having a late night drink. Little nightcap. You go to bed.
It's a string quartet, isn't it?
I don't really know.
Well, I've told you a million times.
Divertimento indeed.
You know, there's no way there's going to be room for all this stuff in the new place.
Yeah, well, you got to be brutal, right?
Hey, look what I found. I found letters.
Then, nothing. Give them here.
Dear Father Christmas. Oh, my God. There's hundreds of them. Dear Santa Claus. Dear Santa. Dear Father Christmas.
No, let's just throw them out, will not
you? Oh, my God. You're not Father Christmas, are you?
Oh. No! Because I'm not Father Christmas. Don't you think that I would have told you if I was Father Christmas?
So why do we never spend Christmas Eve together then, Nicholas?
You're working, isn't it?
What?
No, not working, just out of things. You know what? This is ridiculous. I am not Father Christmas. You know, I hope it's not just me who's got to get rid of half of his sentimental stuff in this move, you know? I hope you're going to be just as ruthless with your old stuff.
After the reconstruction of the management team, the project ran consistently on time and under budget.
Very good. Now, it says here on your CV that your interests include knife throwing. I haven't seen that very often.
Ha. Huh.
Very impressive. I hope you don't mind. I took the liberty. Here are some knives.
Look sharp.
If you could, just for instance, hit this apple off my head.
What?
Please.
Normally, there's just more precautions with
knives.
I'm not going to tell anyone, please.
Okay. Give it up. Hold on. Okay, ready?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, God, that's just... I'm just going to give another go. I'm going to give another go. Don't even think about it. Just hold on. Okay, ready? And... Oh,
my God, I
shall I give it another go?
No, it's fine. It's fine, just Shirley, can you bring in some bandages, please? Oh. You should know that we will expect you to travel a bit in the first year.
I'm flexible, so it's fine.
Sorry, I just want to say that there might be one tiny white lie
on the CV. Sorry.
It's fine. Everyone does it.
You know what I love?
What?
The taste of cock. Mm-hmm. I love the way it looks. I love the color. Yeah, it's chocolate that I like. It's not cock at all. It's chocolate. Okay. I don't really think I like the taste of cock.
Okay.
But chocolate.
Stop talking now.
Hello, police.
Hello. Hi, I'm in a hot air balloon and it appears to have popped.
Please go away, Karen. I'm really, really, really busy.
But it's so much fun.
Not for me. I'm dying inside.
Listen.
What?
You know that boy?
Yes.
You said like me?
Yes.
And then he got my number?
Yes.
Why hasn't he called me?
Because you're mental. Goodbye. Hello, police.
I know he's there for me.
Happy anniversary.
Oh, you remembered.
Of course I did. Right, now I want you to close your eyes.
What have you done?
Nothing, just close your eyes. The surprise.
Oh God, you know I don't like surprises.
Well, you're gonna like this one.
Okay.
Up the stairs.
Can I open them now?
No.
Please.
In a bit.
Can I open them now?
No.